6x6 center tips that I kind of use actively in my sauce. Okay, some of these are actually common things that other people have said before, but I do have a bit of unique ones. And okay, the first one is kind of something that I don't really see that much, which is like, let's say I've already solved the first center and I want to solve the second center. So I make a bar, but I don't want to insert it right away. What I usually do, in fact, I do this majority of the time, is actually I try to make a second bar first. So in this case, I have a second bar. Then I'll insert these two together in one move instead of like trying to insert the first bar and insert the second bar. And I think normally this case works better when there are fewer pieces on top. In this case, it works really well because like there's only two, so I can remove these two and insert these two at the same time. Okay, the second thing, I think this one is quite common, but it's related to the 5x5 case. So basically, this is a very, very common case that I think most people recognize. If you see a T on 5x5 and you have one piece here, you can actually just use this one to knock out the whole bar. Then you turn this, and then you get a 2x3 block. So on 6x6, the same logic applies, except that now it looks slightly different. So actually what I have here is a T, and oh yeah, I forgot to mention, I use Yao as my main method. So everything that I mentioned here is compatible with Yao, and if you use reduction, you can more or less still use the same techniques. So back to the case here, this is like the T, and there's one piece here that matches the intersection point, and all you need to do is just match it up and go down like that. But okay, I'm going to recycle this cube for another case later. And okay, another thing here is, okay, this is also another very common tip that most people will do. You have a lot of like small like 2x1 strips here, or at least like you find an easy way that to build a 2x4 block. Like in this case, I already have a 2x3 block here being built. Sometimes it's a 2x2 on the side, sometimes it's maybe a 2x2 on the corner. So let's say if I put this piece here and I can match these two up like that, and I turn it like that and move it down, I will get the 2x4 block. So that's just one example, but in general, like you can kind of try to look for 2x4 blocks, like instead of just solving straight bars. Once again, I actually want to recycle this cube for another case, so just bear in mind. Okay, another thing you can do is to build a 2x4 like block in the middle instead of on the side. So like this happens when you can build a 4x4 center, and then you can just pair two up like that and insert. But then there's another thing that that you can do, which is the fat T. So for example, in this case, you can match this one with these two, and then you insert this bar on top like that. And sometimes when you make a fat T, this one you have to be a bit careful because you cannot have too many of the other stuck pieces outside. Namely, if you have one here and one's already here, then you should avoid doing the fat T, because like it means you cannot make that block here because you need one of each type. So in this case, I can, because even though this one is used up, I still have at least one of each other piece type to include. So what I'll do here is, okay, these two are the same type, so I look for the other one that is different, like this one and this one. They'll match like that. And then I can insert and knock it out just like the 5x5 T. But here, there are two ways to knock it out. The first is to do this, and the second is to do this. And obviously, the second method is better. And finally, okay, these two are a bit of crazier stuff there. I've already solved a yellow center, and I know the next color is supposed to be blue, but what I would do sometimes, or actually if I catch an easy case, let's say, here I purposely set up an easy case for green because it's the wrong color. So let's say I'm doing yellow, I know blue is next, but instead green looks very easy. What I'll do is I'll just ignore it and just solve green in this place. And here I can actually diverge into two different routes. I mean, yeah. So the first one is to actually solve a full center in the wrong place. So this one is usually more common with opposite centers, and I've also seen some advanced cubers do it. So do another block, insert it here, and then do another block, and insert it down there. And then after that, white, okay, I got a full bar in this one, so I can insert it like that. Then insert this one like that. And then okay, solve the last bar. And then after that, I will switch to opposite centers. Okay, the reduction version is slightly shorter, but because I'm using Yao, I have to protect my cross, so I will usually do it like that. Another thing I would do is actually, I would solve half of a center in the wrong place sometimes. So for example, green is here. The next color is supposed to be yellow because I'm doing red. So I have a white bar here, and then instead of solving a third white bar here, what I will do sometimes is I'll solve the third white bar on top, like that. And instead of bringing this one down to the white face, I'll bring this one up like that. And then yeah, I'll just finish off the whites. And then just nice, I got a yellow center here, so might as well.